गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 5. आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर जस्ट सेफ एक्टिव एंड हेल्दी एट योर होम्स. एंड आई थिंक ऑल ऑफ यू आर जस्ट गोइंग थ्रू योर ऑल द ऑनलाइन क्लासेस रेगुलरली. सो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हियर आई एम योर साइंस टीचर मिसेज आरती नेगी. एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी very important, very informative topic from our science subject, that is safety at home. As you know that all of us loves and lives at our homes, and we used to find our home the safest place in this world. But you know students, if we will not remain alert, then accident may even happen at our home also. So while walking, while moving around, while looking at something, while searching for something at our homes, we must stay alert all the times, because if we will not remain alert, then accident may happen, and because of that we will face too many problems. So today here I am going to tell you about different types of safety measures that we must keep in our mind whenever we are doing anything in our home. So first safety measure we are going to discuss here is a safety from fall. Yes, that is a major issue that can arise at your home. So whenever you are just standing nearby your balcony or near to your windows without grills, just be very careful. If you will lean down too much, then you may fall from there and you may get hurt. So whenever standing near the balcony or near the window, just stand straight, don't lean. Next is, if you are using any furniture like the drawers, never step on these drawers, because whenever you are trying to step on these drawers, the complete furniture may just fall down over to your body, and then you will get major injuries. Same in the next image. Whenever you are going to take something from high cabinets, don't use a delicate stools by your own. Just take help from your elder brother or sister or from your parents. Otherwise, you may fall down and you may injure your body. Next is, never run on the wet floors. Means, after mopping the floor, just turn on the fan so that the floor gets dry easily and fast. And whenever you are using the bathroom after bathing, always clean your bathroom so that the next person who is coming to the bathroom, or even you also, will not slip on the wet surface. Okay students, so always make it sure that your floors are dry and not wet. And if it is water spilled over there, just mop that area quickly and let it dry fast. Next is, if you are going through the stairs, then never run on the stairs, okay? Because if you will run there, then you might fall from the stairs and this will lead to a injury in your body parts. So here are some steps that you can follow while going towards going from the stairs. First, stay alert means whenever you are moving from the stairs, never have a phone or a toy or any or a reading newspaper, nothing will be there to that can distract your mind, okay? That may lead to fall. Next one is whenever you are walking, or you can say whenever you are going through the stairs, just keep your steps carefully. Next, don't run over the stairs. Next, if anything is placed there like toys, shoes or another objects, just watch each and every steps carefully so that you can avoid these obstacles easily without getting damaged by these things. And last and very important thing, that is whenever you are using the stairs, always use handrail that is present at the sides of the stairs. Either it is present on both side or a one side. So always use handrails whenever you are walking through the stairs. So by keeping all these things in your mind, you can prevent the damages that may arise due to fall. Next one is safety from fire. Yes, students, this is very important for you to keep this in your mind that there are some main reason of fire at home. The first reason is cooking, that is present in your kitchen. The gas stoves, the burners, the inductions, all the things. Next one is heating. Heating means like heaters, okay? Next one is electrical appliances. And last one is cigarette or candles. So these are the four main reasons because of that the fire can happen at your homes. So always keep in mind, never play near the hot appliances. Means never play near your backside of refrigerator. Never play in your kitchen near the gas stoves. Never play with the iron or a juicer mixers or a washing machines. Means never play with the home appliances at your home. Next is don't touch the electrical outlets, means the switchboards, the plugs, don't play with them. Next one is don't play with fire like matchbox, the lighters, candles, fire sticks, agarbatti, dhubatti that is present at your home. Never play with such articles present at your home. And always try to install a fire extinguisher at your home with the help of your parents. And not only just purchase it from the market and put it at your home. Students also learn how to use these firefighting equipments during the case of fire. Suppose आपने market से लेके घर में इसको रख दिया, लेकिन अगर आपको ये use करना ही नहीं आएगा तो आप इसको time पड़ने पर इसका use नहीं कर पाओगे. So it is very important after purchasing firefighting equipments, always read the instructions carefully that how to use it, so that if if a fire is there due to some reason, then you can easily turn off that fire with the help of various firefighting equipments or even with the use of water also. But you cannot use water in all the types of fires. So there must be a firefighting equipment at your home in a working condition all the time. Now next topic is safety from electric shock. Yes, again a very important topic for you all. As you know, nowadays our home is equipped with too many types of electrical appliances and electric wires, electric switches, plugs, etc. So always keep in mind, student, never play with electric wires, electric appliances, electric switches, plugs, anything, because it may damage your body parts. You may get electrocuted, and because of that your body will suffer a lot of problem. So never play with the electrical things and stay away from them. Next one is safety from poisoning. Again, very important for you. Your house may be having the different types of chemicals, like Harpic, the floor cleaner, that is a phenyl, the choline, the bike washing chemicals, car washing chemicals, battery water. There are, students, lots of types of chemical we used to have at our homes for different purposes. And you know, these chemicals are very dangerous for you, even for your skin, for your eyes, for your nose, for all your sense organs. So never play with such materials present at your home. And there are lots of medicines also present at our home. So if you will find any tablet, any syrup, any medicine at your home, don't try to have it by your own. Okay, this may lead to poisoning in your body and you will feel sick after having them, and sometimes this problem would be very serious. So never take any such materials by your own at your home. So stay away from such things. Now, students, our next topic is first aid. You know what is the meaning of first aid? First means, you know the meaning of first, that is first, and means first time, and aid means the help given. Means if a person is injured, the first help given to that injured person is called first aid. And you always have a first aid at your home in a full working conditions, and you must have different types of articles in your first aid box, like the bandages, the gauze roll and pad. Gauze roll means simply a simple bandage, white bandage with a cotton, and a cold pack, elastic bandage, an emergency blanket, antiseptic wipes, a thermometer, a doctor tape, gloves, emergency contact numbers, or you can say the family history of the allergies, a scissor, a tweezer, a triangular bandage, and some safety pins. These are the basic things that must be present in your first aid box every time at your homes, so that if any accident happens at your homes to any person, then you can give him the first aid immediately with the help of this first aid box. Now I will tell you that what kind of a first aid should be given to a injured person. First type is a cut and scratches. If a person is having the problem of cut or scratches, first of all just wash that area. But do remember this thing, if the cut is not too deep, if it is a shallow cut, then wash that area with the help of soap and water, then clean it with a piece of cotton, and then cover it with the bandage. And if you have any antiseptic, then you can apply that antiseptic ointment over that cut. Next kind of injury is burn. If there is a minor burn, then first of all just place that area under the water. Then use a antibiotic ointment on that burn, and then easily cover it with the help of bandage. And if the person is having too much of pain, then he or she can take a painkiller also. But do remember one thing, if the burn is severe, then immediately rush to the doctor or a clinic quickly. And if there is any blisters occur, then don't try to pop that blister. And don't use oil, butter, ghee over the burned area. And never use any toothpaste or any other kind of remedies on that burned area. Okay, so these were the first aid for the burnt areas. Now next one is a first aid for the person who got electrocuted. Means if a person get an electric shock, then what kind of a help you can give to him? First, quickly just turn off the switch socket, or just unplug the cord from the electricity board. Then if you cannot turn on the current, then try to use a wooden stick or the broom that is easily available at your home, or a plastic material or a doormat, to cut the circuit between the person and the wire, and then quickly rush to the doctor, to the nearest hospital as soon as possible. Next one is the first aid given to the person who have poisoned accidentally. First of all, try to get to know that what kind of material the person have took. Then watch for his breathing process. If he is breathing normally, then try to lay him down in its side position, then so that the person can vomit easily. But if his condition is so serious, then quickly go to the nearest hospital possible. So students, these were the different types of first aid given to the injured person. Now that's it for today, and try to learn all these things taught to you by me in our today's class, so that you will remain fit at your home without any problem. And if you'll find any problem at your home, then you can easily give first aid to the injured person. So that's it for today, students. Thank you. Be at your home, be safe, and learn regularly through your online classes. Thank you.